Akon speaks on R.Kelly's conviction. Senegalese-American singer and record producer Akon has weighed in on the situation facing his fellow singer R.Kelly after he was convicted recently in his federal sex crimes trial. Akon shared his thoughts when TMZ caught up with him as asking what he thinks about the verdict. Akon stated, and I'm quoting, "I believe God makes no mistakes. People can debate back and forth all day, but if it's happening to him, it's supposed to happen to him for whatever reason. That's God's reason as to why it's going down. Now, that's something he has to have within himself to reevaluate his whole life, his way of being, to get caught up in a situation like that. Whatever happens is between him and God." He continued saying, "There's always a way to redeem yourself, but you have to first accept the fact that you are wrong or in a position for that particular purpose and why you're being there in the first place. Now, just so you know, R. Kelly is looking at 10 to life, 10 years to life in prison when he is sentenced next year, as the embattled singer was found guilty of all 9 federal counts, including sex crimes, kidnapping, human trafficking, racketeering, and obstruction of justice. He is, however, still facing another federal trial in Chicago and 2 other state trials for similar charges."
This is what I'm going to say. I like the fact that Akon didn't do this thing that a lot of people do where they say, oh, it's, you know what, it's my friend.
Because he's a black man.
No, not even that. Because he's my friend. Let me, okay, you know, let me cover up for him. Like, this is him coming out to say, you know what, if you're in this situation, you're in this situation for a reason. And like he said, it's between you and God. Between you, God, and the courts. Because at the end of the day, my brother. And again, it's just very sad, this whole R. Kelly thing. When you even hear the things that they even accuse him of, you're just like, this is the same R. Kelly that is...
I don't think it's shocking. He has been facing these accusations for, 2 decades?
Yeah,
almost 20 true. Years. Starting off from the Aaliyah story in 1994, yeah, where it was like a rumor, did he marry Aaliyah at 15? Did he forge a marriage certificate when he was 19? And then after that, it's still just 1 year after the Aaliyah scandal, another 17-year-old comes up. And then like 2 years after, it was another 19. His intern. It was just back to back. You hear people coming out to say the same thing. What about the little child he peed on, the 14-year-old?
Yeah,
what about the two girlfriends he came that one of them wanted? I mean, if you follow this story back to back, I don't feel absolutely anything like... I was actually excited. Like, when I heard that R. Kelly, I was actually like, good. Yeah, because
finally,
you can't be doing something for 20 years. The one in, was it 1995 or so, I'm not really sure, he paid her off $250,000. And he kept doing that. So you keep obstructing justice because you're R. Kelly, because you're a big musician. And then you now use that card of, oh, I'm a musician, I'm a black man, so people are coming for me. No, that's not what's going on. You are actually committing crime. So the first stage for him is to actually come out and say, I did this. I mean, forget about Bill Cosby and all of that, because Bill Cosby is out, so...
Especially with the other girl, Clary, who recently came out to say that her defending R. Kelly was rehearsed.
You see
and
now.
And taught them what to say. So right now, the whole thing is getting dicey and there's just too many new revelations coming up that need to be investigated. So, I don't know, I think... I just hope this whole case is settled and done for at once. Because
for me,
it's been dragging for too long.
I feel
for
it's a
me,
good step.
This is a problem I have in this entire situation. It's already hard being a black man in America. Let's start from there. Like, black people are already suffering on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. You don't now want to be the person to now give people the reason
exactly
why we should look bad.
Exactly.
Word.
Exactly. And that's exactly what he's doing.
Exactly. Word. And because you're also an influential person, they're just going to be like, oh, see you when they make money, they don't change. Mm. That's what they're going to be saying in their... Let me know. Go inside.
And then they start using a particular... They start looking at rich black people in a particular way. Like,
I feel like people like this... I mean, he's not the only musician that's been called out for stuff like this. They have strange fetishes and nobody is there to actually tell them what is right and what is wrong. Mm-hmm. And I think that moving forward, if you have friends that are in the media and you know that they're doing something wrong, don't feel the need to cover up for them just because they are popular. Actually point it out to them that what you're doing is wrong and you should stop. So, I mean, we wish R. Kelly all the best.